Welcome to the Crab Diving Show with your hosts, Ryan Pfeiffer and Patrick Vile.
Mike Huckabee was on a wonderful television show hosted by a pinnacle of morality and grace and love of the Lord.
You are a pinnacle of shittiness.
He was on Jim Baker's show.
Oh, God damn.
Jim Baker!
Hey, Mike Huckabee, I want to see the list of people he says no to for an interview.
I think we could get him.
I was about to say the same fucking thing. He said yes to Jim Baker. I'd be like, no, I'm not going on Jim Baker. It makes me look like a shithead.
So here's a little bit. Listen to a little bit of this. Of this conversation, Mike Huckabee and Jim Baker.
Oh, God.
Probably arguing over who's the biggest bullshit artist.
Right. Kate, get my heroin.
Doesn't Huckabee sell survival shit too?
I don't know. Does he?
I think he might, like on his website. Like he might.
Do you remember the clip we played where Jim Baker breaks down the pricing of his fucking desserts? This freeze-dried desserts.
$2,000, you could have 4 years of freeze-dried desserts once Jesus comes.
Yeah, you can ride out the zombie apocalypse on like powdered cheesecake. Wonderful. He's like, you could get 3,500 desserts for the price of 5,000.
Here's a little bit of Huckster B and Jim the Felon Baker.
Christians have become second-class citizens.
Fuck
there's
you.
The,
fuck everyone.
The opening.
God.
There's the opening.
They have not.
Jim Baker.
They have not become. Listen.
Yeah.
No one.
Pull out a dollar bill.
No one's persecuting you in this fucking country, okay?
Flip the back of a dollar bill. Tell me what's written on it.
I don't know about you at Vile Experience, but at Rated R Comedy thinks we live in Christian Disneyland. We do!
And the reason they're squealing is because other people are starting to go, hey, maybe we want some rights too.
Fuck you. Eat a
You're
dick.
Persecuting us.
There was a movie called, what was that Mel Gibson movie about Jesus?
The Passion of the Christ.
Yes. How much money did that make? How many people saw that? There are plenty of you here.
That was torture porn.
And no one is persecuting you.
Right.
No one.
That was torture porn.
No one's persecuting Christians. Do you in this country? Do you agree with me?
I agree. And if they are, I would stand with the Christians.
Yeah. Yes. Of course.
But telling you that you can't ram your Jesus into my butthole,
yes,
isn't persecuting you.
Right. I mean, can you imagine somebody running for president and they're just like, hey, I just want to get this out of the way. I'm a straight up atheist. Okay.
Oh.
Let's move on. Let's move on to other issues.
We're a long way from that. A long way from that.
Well, what do you think happens after you die? Nothing. I turn into mulch. Next question.
Christians have become second-class citizens in our nation, and you say that's wrong.
Well, it's not only wrong, but it defies everything that our country was intended to be.
Now, he's not saying that's wrong as in it's not factual. He's saying it's wrong that Christians have become. They're accepting the fact that Christians are second-class citizens.
In all seriousness,
and that's wrong.
Mike Huckabee looks like a fucking parade balloon float.
Meanwhile, a giant Chiron at the bottom splashed across says, for a donation of $30 or more, you get a visit with Governor Mike Huckabee, the 3-hour DVD and book.
Shit.
And there's a P.O. box in Branson, Missouri.
Who makes his suits? Whoever makes Huckabee suits must be like, okay, it's time to go get another bolt of fucking fabric.
A lot of cotton plants
that is
gave their lives for that.
Oh, yeah.
Or a lot of caterpillars shat out miles worth of stuff.
18 kids in Indonesia worked for 4 months on that suit jacket.
Mm-hmm. Which is a place where religious liberty would be practiced by everyone and anyone. And now it seems like we will protect the rights of almost any religion except Christians.
That is such cocking bullshit.
Everyone fuck off. Everyone, please. I'm talking to you, Mike Huckabee.
Meanwhile, I don't know what the technology is going on here over on the Jim Baker Show, jimbakershow.com. But Huckabee is wearing one of those Janet Jackson mics on that goes around the side of your head.
Does he get up and
like,
dance?
Why would?
Because he's going to dance in a second.
Why wouldn't you have a
Jim
a
Bakker
TV show? Why wouldn't you have like a lavalier or a, even a boom mic or both? Why would you have your guest sit there with a ridiculous mic on the side of his
what
head?
What the fuck kind of set does the Jim Bakker show have going on? By the way, I mean,
it's supposed to look like a warm and it's a warm living room, Ryan.
How does he have a set? Now I'm just thinking about Jim Bakker's career and the fact that it fucking exists. This is a man peddling freeze-dried fucking desserts.
Yeah.
You can buy tarts by the 5,000 from this guy for some reason. I don't understand.
Of course, here's a...
Let me understand. I'm sorry. So Jim Bakker sells desserts. And he also interviews big, fat, right-wing nut job assholes. He does those two things.
Yes.
Okay, I got it.
Here's a story from a couple of years ago from the Daily Mail about Jim Bakker. The headline is, "Disgraced televangelist Jim Bakker now sells apocalyptic survivalist gear." and enema kits.
Shut up.
To his
Hold
followers.
On. No.
Enema kits, all in caps.
You know, whoever wrote that headline, I would have done the same thing. I would
all
have
caps.
All caps. Oh, enema kits. Enema kits. What?
Among his books are "Prosperity and the Coming Apocalypse,"
right?
In which he touts his belief in the undetermined return of Jesus. And urges his followers to be prepared.
Clear out your colon, too.
In that vein, he and his wife are selling a number of apocalypse-themed products aimed at helping their fans prepare for the
apocalypse? Let me ask you something. When you watch Walking Dead, do you remember a scene when everybody had to break out the enemas?
Thank you for listening to Crab Diving. Catch the crabs on Facebook. Facebook.com/crabdiving and on Twitter and Instagram @crabdiving.